ஸ்ரீ குருபியோ நமஹ சில்ட்ரன், வெல்கம் டு அவர் ஆன்லைன் கிளாஸ். டுடே செஷன் இஸ் வெல்கம் டு அவர் ஆன்லைன் கிளாஸ் சில்ட்ரன். த சப்ஜெக்ட் இஸ் பயாலஜி, த டாபிக் இஸ் மைக்ரோ ஆர்கானிசம் 8th ஸ்டாண்டர்ட். ஷல் வி ஸ்டார்ட் த லெசன் சில்ட்ரன்? Today we are going to see the useful effects of microorganism. See, already told you, no, useful effects of microorganism. Yesterday we saw that, see, useful microorganism, see here, there's the four field. We saw that four field, no, in the main four field, the microbes are used in different ways. Okay, first one is the medicine field. Second one is agricultural field. Third one is industrial field. Then fourth one is the in daily life. Last session we saw that medicinal uses. Okay. In medicinal field, microbes are used to prepare the antibodies, vaccine and food supplement. Isn't it? Today we are going to see the uses of microbes in agricultural field. How the agricultural field microbes are used. Okay. See, let's start. In agricultural field, microbes are used in three ways. I told you now. One is the natural fertilizer. Second one is the nitrogen fixation. Third one is the biocontrol agent. Okay. First one is the natural fertilization. See, natural fertilizer. Fertilizer means it is the nutrition. Fertilizer means nutrition. This nutrition, which is, we know very well. See, listen. We know very well. If a human being needs some important nutrients for their growth, for example, protein, carbohydrates, fats like that, as well as plants also need some essential nutrition for their growth. NPK, nitrogen, potassium, phosphorus is the major essential nutrition for the growth of plants. Okay, so fertilizer means the nutrition which need for the plants, it is called the fertilizer. Are you clear? So how the microbes are used for making the fertilizer? You know that fertilizers are two types. Okay, one is the chemical fertilizer, another one is the natural fertilizer. Chemical fertilizer means the fertilizer is made up of fully chemicals, but these fertilizers giving the awful effect to the human world, human being as well as the animals. Okay. But the natural fertilizers, there no, it does never give any harmful effects to the consumers like animal and the human beings. Okay, so microbes are used to prepare the natural fertilizer. Natural fertilizer means, for example, farmers dug the, in ancient day, what they did, see, they dug the well. They dug the well, they put everything, they filled the gap, everything, the household wastes like fruit peels and then vegetable peels, that like household wastes and cow dung, dried leaves, the tree parks, everything they stored in the gap. Okay, then what happened, see, after that, this gap is continuously filled. After the moisture, some fungi and bacteria, microbes grown on that waste materials, they absorb the nutrients from the waste materials and then they let out the nitrates. They absorbing the nutrients from this waste material, wastes, then they let out the nitrates and other some inorganic nutrients into that waste material. So that waste materials then turn into a compost. Compost means the fertilizer, natural fertilizers. Okay, so the microbes are called decomposers. Decomposers means, already we saw that fungi having the saprophytic nutrition could have it. Okay, saprophytic means they growing on the waste material, waste and degradable material. They absorbing nutrient from that waste material, then they let out the nitrogen wastes into that material. Okay, that waste materials then converted into a composed, that composed to the fertilizer. So it is called this way, microbes are used to making the natural fertilizer. Isn't it? Next one is the second topic is the nitrogen fixation. Nitrogen fixation means nothing that, see, we know very well in the atmosphere, nitrogens are present in 78%. Okay, the 78% of nitrogen present in the atmosphere. So these nitrogens are observed, these the atmospheric nitrogens are observed some special plants, some specified plants. Okay, for example, leguminous plants. Leguminous plants means that the pea plants are called. Pea plants are called. The pea plants means like what is that? We are saying patani, avarai, tovarai. That is the pea plants. These plants are called the leguminous plants. Okay, these type of plants having the special root noodles. They having their root noodles. Root noodles means some beans-like structure is there. That beast-like structure actually having the rhizobium bacteria. Are you clear? Rhizobium bacteria living in the plant of leguminous plants root noodles. Root noodle is there like a beak-like structure in the root. It is called the root noodles. This root noodles having rhizobium bacteria. This bacteria absorbing the nitrogen from the air and stayed this air nitrogens into the soil. So become the soil is very nutrient and nitrogen is fixed into the soil. It is called the nitrogen fixation. The best example is cyanobacteria and nostoc also used for fixing the nitrogen into the soil. Then next one is the biocontrol agents. Bio means living, control means they controlled. Okay, agents means them. One living thing control the other living thing. It is the biocontrol agent. Okay, see, microbes are used to protect the crops from pest. Pest means which animal giving the awful, which animal destroyed the growing crops, the part of the plant, some animals, they feed that part of the plant and destroy the growing crops. That animals are called the pest. Isn't it? See, the best example, pest is rat and then squirrels, insects, bees and then grasshoppers. They are called the pest because they are feed the parts of the plants. They're destroying the parts of the plant. Like so some insects are destroying the root part and some other the grasshoppers are destroying the sheath part of the plant and then squirrels are destroying the nuts. And then leaf parts. So these animals are called the pest. Okay, see, some microbes are used to control these pests. Okay, that's why it is called the biocontrol agent. The example is the Bacillus thuringiensis. Bacillus thuringiensis is a bacteria. This bacteria is used to control the insect pest. Okay, the next one is the Trichoderma. Trichoderma is a fungi. This fungi is helped to control the plants of pathogen root part of the plant. Okay, next one is the papilloviruses. This virus attack the insect and other arthropods also. This papillovirus is used to control the arthropods as well as insects. Are you clear, children? Okay, next is third Roman letter. Tomorrow we will see. Okay, children, today's session is over. Thank you, children.